Hello, ladies and gentlemen, this is Giant Grant Games, and over the past few weeks, the modmaker Synergy and myself have been working on something pretty exciting, the Wings of Liberty Randomizer. Randomizers are incredibly popular in other forms of games, and we would like to bring some of that dynamic fun to StarCraft II. How do you make a proper randomizer in StarCraft II that isn't broken, though? Well, here's how it works. Instead of true randomness, whenever you produce a unit from a structure, you get a unit from a pool of eligible units. For example, on the barracks, you can spend 60 minerals and 10 gas to get a random basic unit. These range from garbage, such as the Quilgore, to decent, like the Whirlwind's Ire Zealot. Or you can spend 75 minerals or 75 gas to get a support unit. These units range from things like sentries, to medics, to queens. Each tier has a set cost, and while the units are generally of similar quality, you might end up scoring something pretty good for the price, or you could end up paying a bit of a markup. You can get a fairly good feel for each pool of units, but the pools themselves are too large to reliably grab a specific composition. The units are available from all four campaigns, as well as the multiplayer. Co-op units are not included because they overlap a ton and they trivialize most of the content. Once you have all of your units, it's time to get some attack and armor upgrades. Because it's unreasonable to expect players to get 16 different sets of upgrades, they're all bundled into one set of attack and armor upgrades on the engineering bay. To compensate for the ease of access, the price has been increased a bit. Some units are completely and totally overpowered, such as the Narazim DTs or Arbiters. These units are not available from the standard production structures. Instead, you're going to have to try your luck on the Mercenary compound. Additionally, the final two tiers of Mercenaries have some very special units that can be rolled. All of the Armory upgrades are available by default, making some of the less used Wings of Liberty units have a stronger place in the game. And each Laboratory tier is randomly rolled at the beginning of the mission. All of the boss enemies, such as the Motherships, the Leviathans, and Kerrigan herself, have had pretty massive buffs, because boss fights are awesome. If this sounds like it's up your alley, Wings of Liberty Random Edition is now available under the campaign tabs of the arcade. And if you need a little bit more convincing, you can watch my playtesting the mod here. We worked really hard to make this a random adventure that would fit inside of the mechanics of StarCraft. Good luck, and have fun.